Swagus 101, the ongoing on-air adult education course that teaches men how to get more tail for less money. More importantly, we teach women how men think. I am your professor. This is my classroom. Class is in session. This is where we teach the tenets of Lycus 101. I've been teaching them for a long time now, and many of you new to the class, remind you just some of the basics. Lycus 101 students, proud to be known as jerks or a-holes. If a woman calls us a jerk or an a-hole or attempts to slap our face, we know we're doing it right. We believe in the three strikes, you're out theory. If a woman does not put out in the first three dates, you move on to the next. You don't waste your time pounding your head against the wall. We don't spend more than $40 on a date. We don't date single mothers. We don't go on coffee dates or lunch dates. The reason for being with a chick is to put the biscuit in the basket. That's it. We don't go on dates to find out some chickie's political opinions or to see how intelligent or educated she is. We want to see her knockers. That is what we're there for. We want to taste every square inch of you, ladies. That's what we want. We have no interest in hearing about your pets, your ex-boyfriend, how your boss mistreats you. It's all a complete waste of our time. Being that this is an electronic classroom, many of you write in with questions or comments. You write to this address, tom@blowmeuptom.com. tom@blowmeuptom.com. Tandy writes in and says, "Hi, Tom. I am a female raising a three-year-old boy solo. I'm an avid listener to your program, even though I don't care too much for the way women are portrayed and the message that you send the men."
Darling, that's how I know I'm doing it right.
"Basically, while I'm outraged, at the same time, I'm compelled to listen. Go figure. See, I'm a jerk, and you are fascinated. Anyway," says Tandy, "I have just one question for you. I'm perplexed because one of the Lycus 101 rules espouses that men, when on dates, should be alarmed when the woman's cell phone rings." In fact,
that's not what I said. It's not just that a man should be alarmed. Don't be alarmed, men. What I said is that if a woman's cell phone rings and she answers it, you simply get up from the table, excuse yourself like you're going to the bathroom, and then leave her stranded at the restaurant. That's what I said. No cause for alarm.
She says, "You go on to say that the caller will just be a boyfriend waiting for the woman when she leaves her date. You instruct the man to get up and leave, terminating the date. Why would the man care one way or another? The ultimate goal, as you put it, is to have sex with the woman. No commitments, no marriage, nothing, just sex. A cell phone call, for whatever reason, shouldn't preclude the goal of sleeping with the woman, right? What am I missing?" Well, dear, when that cell phone rings in the middle of the date, it's not just a guy who wants to have sex with her. It's a guy who's planning on having sex with her tonight if he can get his hands on her. And if she takes the call in the middle of the date, that means I'm paying for dinner. And she plans to tell me, "Oh, my God, look at the time, it's 9:30, I got to go to bed." But in reality, she's going to hook up with a guy who's calling on the cell phone during dinner. And by the way, I have also said on this program and this classroom that the only other possibility for that cell phone ringing during a date is that it's the babysitter calling to say something about the child at his home. And that's another reason to leave, because if she has a babysitter, she has a child, that's not somebody you want to be with. It's that simple. Tandy, keep listening. It'll all make sense. Here's a listener who did not sign a name. He lives in Santa Clarita, California. "Tom, I'm a 30-year-old good-looking male that is recently divorced. She was my high school sweetheart, and we married young.
I thought you would get a kick out of this story, so here it goes. We were going out at 15 and married at 20. We did not have sex before we got married, and on the wedding night, she was afraid to. Well, believe it or not, I tried throughout the years to be patient and understanding about this. We had a great life together with a house, cars, etc., but no sex life. I know you're thinking, how can I stay in a relationship like this? Since my divorce 8 months ago, a friend tuned me into your show. I have been on many dates, and I'm getting used to the dating scene, and listening to your show really has helped me. To top it off, my ex-wife has moved to Ohio to be with a guy she met on the Internet. She says he doesn't treat her as nicely as I did, and she gives him sex, among other things. I wonder if he's a Likas 101 student. Keep up the good work. Listener in Santa Clarita. Another listener, unsigned. Hello, Tom. Your show kicks ass on all topics. What's the best place to meet low self-esteem women? Thanks. Need to know. I think I've answered this question recently, but the place to meet low self-esteem women is any place attractive women congregate. I mean the hot ones. Bars in rich neighborhoods, restaurants and nightclubs in rich neighborhoods. If you live in Southern California, any nice club in Beverly Hills. Because hot chicks are competing with each other and they've got low self-esteem. Bottom line. Another listener writes in, he signed his name J. That's it. J, letter J. That's it. Tom, for some weird reason, my brother, who is 15, and I, 18, we're born with the knowledge that many men seek from you every day. We're both just naturals. We listen to you every day and are constantly agreeing with you and learning from you. About 3 weeks ago, I found that this hot girl who I went to school with wanted to get with me. So I hung out with her and hooked up, but for some reason, my usual methods and skills are useless. I find myself constantly thinking about this girl. Get this, I even call her back when I say I will. I'm getting ultra-sensitive with everything related to her and have decided that I must cut this off now. Tom, I wrote her an effing poem for her birthday. I need to get my mind elsewhere. I come to you for advice on getting this girl cleansed from my head so that the rest of the year can be filled with better things. Your loyal student, JJ. Start banging other chicks. Start banging other chicks. Get away from this chick. Get away. If you start banging other chicks, eventually you would get your mind off it. At your age, 18, you got a lot of testosterone flowing around, and you need to keep pumping. So keep pumping, baby. All right, it's Likas 101. I'm your professor. If you're looking for ways to avoid serious commitment, avoid marriage, avoid spending money, wasting time listening to women going blah, 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 blah. You want to avoid spending your time, which is valuable. It's time you can spend screwing others. Or if you've got issues with your professor and you want to argue here in the classroom, now's the time.
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM.
Boys, I highly recommend that. Tabasco sauce in the condom when you're done with it. Wouldn't you love to catch some bitch doing that?
Honey, I'll be right back. I just got to go to the bathroom.
And they go to the other room. It's like, ah!
It's the Tom Likas Show.
The Tom Likas Show, broadcasting live tomorrow from the Pig and Whistle, all you 101ers out there. Now, Valentine's Day is coming up over the weekend, so, well, I'm not coming in on Saturday to do a show, but tomorrow it's our pre-Valentine's Day broadcast. It'll be a good time to commit to dump that bitch, to come in and tell your story, and by the way, not only will you come see our bizarre live broadcast tomorrow, 6714 Hollywood Boulevard, west of Highland on the south side of Hollywood Boulevard, but also five lucky winners and their guests will be joining me in the private AOL for Broadband Suite for NBA All-Star Saturday night. That's right, we're all going to be at a private suite at Staples Center in the big NBA All-Star Weekend, baby. There's only one way to enter, to win. You can't call in. You can't send an entry on the web. You can't email your entry. You can't come down to the station. No. The only way is to register to win right there at the broadcast tomorrow at the Pig and Whistle. Doors open tomorrow when we say they do. The show begins at 3. I recommend you get there as early as you possibly can. And we'll open the doors when I'm done doing the sound check, which could be 2, 2.15, 2.30. I don't know when. Well, as soon as I don't hear any more feedback, humming, or buzzing, that's when we'll be done with the sound check. Okay, so if I say a time, then they insist on opening the doors at that time. So I'm not committing to a time. Maybe it'll be 2.59 we open the doors. I don't know. You get there early, and when you get in, you can enter to win this contest. And go with me to the NBA All-Star Saturday night. That's the slam dunk competition, skills competition. Sometimes that's better than the goddamn All-Star game. And how often is the NBA All-Star game in L.A.? Every 25 years or so? Hell, there's 30 teams in the NBA, right? Jesus. So, Pig and Whistle, 6714 Hollywood Boulevard, right next to the Egyptian Theater, just east of Highland. And you can call 323-463-uh-oh-uh-oh. If you need directions, details, or anything like that. The Pig and Whistle, 323-463-0000. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Let's say hello to Philip on the Tom Likas Show, 101. Hello.
Hey, Tom, what's up, man?
Not much.
Hey, I got a quick question to ask you. Now, you say if you're in the middle of dinner, lunch, whatever, and a girl answers her cell phone, you're supposed to politely get up and just bail on her.
Bail, yes.
It's either the babysitter.
You know why? Because when I go on a date, I am paying for two things. Exclusivity, right? I'm paying for your time, in other words. That's why I'm paying.
Well, I agree with that.
All right, so the minute the phone, that phone should be turned off, or if it rings, you should ignore it.
But now what if it's a family emergency?
You won't know if it's a family emergency because the phone will be turned off. But what do they do with family emergencies before cell phones? You know what? 7 or 8 years ago, everybody didn't have cell phones.
So you're saying if somebody's calling and it's their family and something bad happens, you're supposed to ignore it?
You shouldn't even know. The phone should be turned off because I'm paying for exclusivity. If the phone is turned on and you get a phone call, I'm out. Out.
I agree with that.
That's it. You know what? Pay for your own dinner. And get your own ride home while you're at.
I wouldn't even give her money for the cab.
Perfect.
I wouldn't even give her money for the payphone.
Perfect.
I just want to say, Tom, you know, it's funny. The other day somebody asked me if I could pick anybody to be my father, who would it be? And I chose you, Tom.
How do you know I'm not your father?
Hey, you probably are, man.
Your mom was hot about 25 years ago. Trust me. Dad had no idea I did her, when he wasn't looking.
That's what the postman said.
I know. I had to wait in line behind him.
All right, Tom, you rock, man.
Philip, thank you. 1-800-5800-TOM. It's Sean on the Tom Likas Show, Likas 101. Hello.
Hey, Tom, how are you?
I'm doing okay, Sean.
Dad, I got a question for you.
Yes, Sean.
Okay. Now, you know, you say we don't, you know, when we're going out with a girl, and all we want to do is pump her. We don't want to hear about all the crapola
right.
About her job and
yep.
Her career and that. So when you got her out to dinner, what do you talk about?
Well, my opinion is that you, first of all, should resolutely resist having dinner with her if you can.
Really?
Yes. What you want to do is, and we have the way to do this. When you're chatting up a chick or you're, like, about to come in for the kill and get some commitment to see her, okay, here's what you do. You call her up on the phone. You say, what time are you having dinner tonight?
Uh-huh.
She'll tell you, I don't know, 7:30, 8 o'clock. Great. So you should be done about 9:30. Why don't we get together for a drink after that?
Oh, perfect.
Then she has no idea that you just stiffed her out of dinner.
I love it.
You go right to the boozing, which is really the most important thing.
Uh-huh.
Then the other thing that you have to remember, very important rule, once you get her out boozing, you want when she's done boozing and you want to cut her off before she gets to the vomit mode, you want to have her hit that zenith, that arc as it were, where she's buzzed enough without hanging her head out your car window like a cocker spaniel. When you want to get her directly from the bar to the sheets. None of this. I know a club that's open all night long. I know an underground club. I know a rave party. I need French fries at Jack in the Box or whatever.
Uh-huh.
Right? If a chick insists on eating on the way home,
yeah.
Here's what you do.
Uh-huh.
You tell her, I'll drop you off at Jack in the Box. I got to head home. I got to work in the morning.
Oh. Okay.
Because I'm telling you, no chick's going to have sex with you with hamburger breath. It's not happening. And nobody likes hamburgers more than I do. But I'm telling you, when it's 2 a.m., it's closing time, and a chick says, can we stop and eat something? She's filibustering. She's trying to avoid having sex with you tonight.
Uh-huh.
What chick is going to have, you know, that taste of palm kernel oil or grease
uh-huh.
on her breath and then put her tongue down your throat? It's not going to happen.
Okay, Tom, so you're at the bar, and while you're getting her intoxicated,
yeah.
Ready, what, in the, you know, she's still, I mean, that takes a while, so you got to talk about something.
You talk about booze, you ask her where she lives, ask her if she has a sister.
The Tom Likas Show.
Tom Likas, only on Hot...
This is the Tom Likas Show.
It's Likas 101. I am your professor at 1-800-5800-TOM Raza. You're on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Tom.
Raza.
I need to ask you something.
All right.
How do I make my girl sign a prenup?
How by telling her you won't marry her unless she signs it?
Oh.
Like a man.
Isn't that going to screw up everything?
No, because if she won't sign a prenup, you don't want to get married to her.
But what's the smoothest way, you know?
The smoothest way is to tell her that if she really loves you, then it's not about money.
That's it. Done.
Because it shouldn't be about money.
Right.
Is she marrying you for money?
I don't think so.
Well, then she should have no problem signing.
Okay.
If she insists on marrying you without a prenup in California, where 2 out of 3 marriages end in divorce, where men routinely get screwed in court, then clearly she doesn't love you. She only wants you for whatever money she thinks you might make.
Okay.
You also tell her,
yeah.
which is true, that you are protecting her as well as you. What happens if she wins the lottery? What happens if she cures cancer? Does she have no... Well, you're laughing. Does she not have any faith in what she will do in the future? Is she telling you she's a loser who will never do anything or create anything of value?
Of course not. No.
Obviously, she should want to protect herself, too.
Yeah, of course.
So the only way she won't be protecting herself is if she never creates anything of value.
All right. All right, Tom, thanks.
So are you going to do that?
Oh, of course, I have to.
You have to get her to sign the prenup, or that's it. Done. It's California, pal.
Well, my dad told me to make her sign the prenup. I just don't know how to do it.
Well, that's how you do it. Well, first of all, you're not getting married without one. You have to make sure she understands that you would never get married without a prenup.
Right.
You know what? The whole world, and I've said it on the radio now for years, the whole world knows I would never get married without a prenuptial agreement, period.
Okay.
The whole world knows this.
All
you
right,
need
right.
to make sure she understands that.
Well, she has to, right?
Well, here's the thing. Have you asked her to marry you?
Yeah.
Do you have a date to get married?
No. Well, the plan is sometime next year.
Don't make a plan.
Okay.
Not until you have a signed prenuptial agreement.
Okay.
If you make a date... Later on, if you have to use the prenuptial agreement, she can say she signed under duress.
Oh, okay.
You don't want that to happen. So before you set a date to get married, you make sure she signs it.
Got it.
If she tries to make a date or she starts telling her friends, it's going to be September 27th. No, tell her, no, it's not going to be September 27th. There is no date.
Gotcha.
Tell her.
I will, tonight. Well, my dad is pushing me to do the same thing as what you're telling me.
Your dad knows what he's talking about. I'm proud he's there.
He told me to listen to you. Thanks.
Not a problem, Reza. Thank you. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. Mitch on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
Hey, what's going on, Tom?
Mitch, not much.
I've been dating this girl for a little over a year. And everything, you know, is going great and everything. And I went off to basic training for the Army. And I come back, and she's just trying to run, like, almost every aspect of my life.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Is there any... I don't want to say wit, but it's close to it. Is there any way that I can, you know, get her to stop without having to...
Yeah, break up with her. Because I'll tell you why. You're 20. You're too young to have a girlfriend. You just went through basic training. Are you telling me that a military officer tells you what to do, and you listen, and then some broad tells you what to do, and you get out of the military? What kind of man are you?
She's a little bit worse than the... drill sergeant thing I went through with.
You shouldn't have a girlfriend before age 25. You're too young.
Too young?
You need to be dipping that wad, baby. Seriously, you need to be sowing your wild oats right now. Why do you need a girlfriend?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just I've never been hooked on a girl like her, you know.
Pal, that's because you're only 20 years old.
Yeah.
They'll be better in the future. What do you plan to become once you leave the military?
Well, I was going to go through a firefighter training.
Uh-huh. And then what were you going to... So you going to stay in the military, career military?
No.
What are you going to do ultimately?
What am I going to what?
What will your career be when you leave the military?
Firefighter.
Firefighter. You know how many chicks are hot for firefighters?
Yeah.
Once you are a firefighter, do you know how many hot chicks are going to be after you?
Yeah, probably a lot.
Yeah. And then you'll be stuck with Miss Bitch telling you what to do.
All right. I hope she's not listening.
What, are you, a pussy?
No, man, but it's just like, well, the girls always control shit because they have...
Pal, you give her the control. You know what? There you are in the military. You're the guy who's going to defend us in case of war. You can't even stand up to your own girlfriend. What if Osama bin Laden was at your front door?
I had no problem with the military aspect of it.
So you're telling me that your girlfriend is more threatening than a terrorist?
She's not threatening. She just withholds. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would be pissed off. I still want to...
She withholds what?
Huh?
She withholds what?
Withholds the sex.
Pal, here's what you do. Have sex with other women. That's you do.
That's true.
That is what you do. You tell her, you don't have to have sex with me, I've got other women to do the heavy lifting, and then you go to them. Stop being bossed around, pal. You are America's finest. You are our military. We need you to be a real man, not a pussy. Stand up like a man. What kind of basic training did you go through? I want to speak to your commanding officer. They're raising pussies in our military. I thought we had real men in the military. Look at you. You're a complete girl.
I am not a complete girl.
You're acting like a complete girl. Nobody can tell you what to do. You're America's finest. You went through basic training. You're America's finest. You're the boss. America rules the world. You tell your girlfriend if she's not putting out, you'll find people who will. That's it. You're a real man. You stand up like a man.
All right. That's true, Tom.
Does you stop being a pussy?
So there's no way. You just either...
No!
Just break up with her?
Yes! Pal, you're too young to have a girlfriend. And she's walking all over you and she's grinding her stiletto heels into your eyeballs. You are a desirable young man with a big future. You are military. You wear a uniform. You plan to be a firefighter, for God's sake. That's desirable. There's plenty of women who would have you. You tell her to get lost. Be a goddamn man, will you? I'm serious.
Man, I am a man, but it's just...
No, you're being a girl. Any girl can tell you what to do. You're a girl.
All right, Tom.
Tell her.
Oh, I will.
Have some goddamn balls. I'm dead serious.
If you acted like it was in the military, they'd put you away.
That's true.
So, what are you doing? You're commanding officers that you answer to, and then you also answer to your girlfriend? Who else do you answer to? Terrorists, enemies, everybody? What? Are you a doormat? What are you?
No, I'm not, and I don't answer anybody.
Stand up. And do not, and by the way, another piece of advice for you, do not get married while you're in the military.
Well, you get paid so much if you get married while you're in the military.
Pal, you get paid, and then they take what you have. Are you hearing me?
You know what BAH is?
Pal, you do you know what a BITCH is?
When you get married, all right, if I go to Iraq, they'll pay.
And you know how many guys who've gone to Iraq who called in and told us when they got back, their girlfriends, wives, fiancés, whatever, are banging other guys or licking other chicks? While you guys are out defending our country, my point to you is you don't get married until you're done with the military. You want to get money and benefits when you're done with the military, when you're done serving your country. You do that in your career later on. You don't do it in the military. Because these chicks put pinholes in condoms, they get you to impregnate them, and then they take whatever benefits they can get from you. Don't be a fool. You've seen it happen to other guys. We hear from them all the time. You think I'm making that up? You know I'm not making that up, don't you?
No, yeah, it's true. I believe
it. I know. So then don't let it happen to you.
Well, all right. I appreciate it, Tom.
I'm here to help.
Tom Likas. 1-800-5800-TOM. 1-800-5800-866.
Well, it's great to talk to you, man. You're like therapy for me.
Thank you.
It's the Tom Likas Show.
Likas on Hot Talk 1080 KOTK.
1-800-5800-TOM. It's Likas 101. I am your professor. Tomorrow, our show will come to you from the Pig and Whistle. Live broadcast in front of a bunch of drunken morons like yourself. Pig and Whistle, Hollywood Boulevard. It's on the south side of Hollywood Boulevard, just east of Highland. And that's right. Don't confuse me with Ryan Seacrest down the block, okay? Please. That's right, next to the Egyptian Theater. Five lucky winners and their guests will join me at the private AOL for Broadband suite for NBA All-Star Saturday night. That's the slam dunk competition, the skills competition. And it only comes to L.A., what, once every quarter century or so. You register to win on site. That's right, you get there, you have to register there. You can't call in. You can't be the 97th caller. You can't enter online. No sending in coupons. You have to be at the Pig and Whistle to win. So get there tomorrow. The Pig and Whistle, 6714 Hollywood Boulevard in Hollywood. And you can call them if you need directions or if you're from the burbs somewhere and you don't get into the city very often. 323-463-ODO-ODO. That's 323-463-UH-OH is the phone number. There you go. 1-800-5800-TOM is our telephone number. It's Frank on the Tom Likas Show. Hello.
How you doing there, Tom?
Pretty damn good, Frank.
Alright, well, you know, just to let you know right off the back, I'm a new student, Likas 101.
Right.
So it's like, you know, I'm coming in kind of late and I'm finding all my mess ups now.
Uh-huh.
For starters, I'm 21. I know that's bad to have a girlfriend at 21.
Strike one.
Matters worse, she's a single parent at 21.
Strike two.
And now she's being obsessive and says she loves me.
Strike three. Okay, yeah. Frank. What do you need, Frank?
I want to know what to do, man. How can you save me? Just
Frank. It's very simple. Get out.
It's kind of hard. Just like
no, it's not. Is that child yours?
No, it's not.
Then it's not hard at all.
I try to go.
It's only hard if the child is yours. The child isn't yours, so get out.
It's not a bad idea.
No, but then you got to do it. You see, the fact that it's not a bad idea is not good enough. You have to do it, like the next time you see her, like tonight.
The thing is, yeah, it's off a long distance.
Where? At the strike four.
Yeah!
Where does she live?
She's in Whittier, California.
Oh, well, you're in Mission Hills and she's in Whittier?
Yeah.
Well, that's not that far. I thought you had to tell me she was in the Maine or something.
No, I'm too lazy to drive to go see her.
I'll tell you what, Frank. We're going to solve that problem right now. We're going to save you the toll call. We'll call her right now. Let's get this over with.
Nah, she's at work right now, and I don't have her number.
Pal, you have her number at work. No, don't. You're lying. You're not going to break up with her. I know you're not going to. You're going to say yes, yes, yes when you're on the air, but you're not going to do it, are you?
Yeah.
Probably not.
Probably not. There you go.
Yeah.
And you know what's going to happen, Frank? And I'm not. By the way, if you call me back, I'm not going to help you. What's going to happen is she's going to put the pinhole in the condom one day. Somehow the condom's going to leak. Are you using condoms? Probably not, right?
Haven't hit it yet.
You haven't hit it? She's your girlfriend? You haven't hit it yet?
I haven't been trying to.
Strike five!
Yeah!
What do you mean? She's your girlfriend, but you've never had sex with her?
Yeah, the kid kind of ruins it.
Pal, you haven't even had sex with her once?
Nah, I've tried, but no.
What kind of girlfriend is it that you haven't had sex with?
One that's been used and won't give it up, no.
Pal, how many times have you been out with her?
Like 7, 8 times.
Strike six!
Yeah!
What is good about this relationship?
I don't know, dude. Like, I guess she makes me happy in some sort of way.
You're a moron.
Yeah, more or less.
You're a complete jerk. No, a jerk would be a promotion. No, you're an idiot. Being a jerk is something to be proud of. You're just stupid.
Yeah.
You're stupid. Yeah, you not date other women as a result of this?
Oh, I date other women. It's just like...
Did you have sex with other women?
Oh, yeah.
So why do you have this chick and call her your girlfriend? Why?
Because she's bought me a pretty good turntable that I use.
She's doing what?
She bought me a record player that I use.
She bought you a record player. That's an investment of the future.
Yeah.
Once you have sex with her and she gets you to take that condom off, assuming you use condoms, you sound like the type who doesn't.
Yeah, you got that one right.
Yeah, there you go. That's good. So you're just heading for this, heading for a brick wall. I mean, one of the chicks you're banging will get pregnant. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
And then you'll be paying child support for the next 18 years. Do you know what that means?
A lot of money.
Do you know how much that is?
Enough.
Let's review. 18 years times 12 months. Do you know how much that is? That's 216 months of child support. Almost 900 weeks of paying some bitch money. Is there an orgasm in the world that's worth that much money?
Hell no.
Pal, you know what? You know, let's look back 18 years. Now, how old you were 18 years ago? Three.
I was three, yeah.
Do you know how old you're going to be in 18 years? 39. That's how long you're going to be paying. Ever think about that?
Nah.
You moron.
Tom Likas, 1-800-5800, Tom. Tom Likas,
1-800-5800-866.
Where do women spend most of their time?
In my wallet.
How about in front of the mirror?
Well, that might be the second place they spend most of their time.
The Tom Likas Show.